Knights of Apollo. What's up, guys? It's Pixelated Apollo. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you guys are doing well. And today I have a treat for you. This is a massive siege battle in Third Age Total War. And when I say massive, that's an understatement. This one is ginormous. There's about 16,000 troops on the battlefield, and we are at one of the most iconic places in Middle-earth. This is the siege of Batador, and you can see the great tower in the background over here. Let me just give you a good view of this place. This is amazing. It looks just like the movie. It's fantastic. So I cannot wait to see this battle unfold before our very eyes, and you can see the orcs storming out of the fortress. The trolls, they're ready to go, ready to meet their enemy on the battlefield. So you can kind of zoom out here real quick so I can give you a good like bird's eye view. It's a little tricky. You got to kind of mess with the tower here. Oh, there's that great eye of Sauron. Look at that. Look at that. That is fantastic. And look at the mini map here. Just look at all of the troops on the battle. That's insane. So this one's going to be a long one. You're going to need your snacks and drinks. This is definitely a great weekend video. So I'm really, really excited to witness this one. This is also a custom scenario made by Sin of the Dark Cloud. So a big shout out to Sin of the Dark Cloud. He has been making some fantastic scenarios lately. I really like the way he does his siege battles because it seems like he has battles that just start right away. He's got his troops ready to go. The battles begin very quickly. That is why we are in slow motion, because we are about to look at the factions and the army comps here today, and the player names, of course. But let's go ahead with let's start with the attackers, the Free Peoples of Middle-earth, who are trying to get rid of the filth of Sauron. So the first army is the High Elves. Most of the armies are High Elves. This one is commanded by Son of Imladris, and he mostly has Eldar Enwë swordsmen, archers, lancers. So very iconic elven armor there. And that's pretty much it. He also has some Mithlin nobles in the mix as well. But that's essentially what his army is consisting of. His general is back here. We got some Eldar Enwë nobles. Moving on to the next player, which is commanded, or the next army, which is the High Elves, commanded by Sir Killy. Very similar army. Lots of Eldar Enwë ready to go. You can see that they've actually taken some casualties here because we have some orcs firing down from the cliffs. We also have a troll catapult in position, ready to fire down, and you can see their massive camps back here. They were getting ready for the siege. This is it, now or never. Take out Sauron and his orc buddies. But yeah, lots of Eldar Enwë. Very similar army. He does have a catapult too, which is going to be useful in choke points. Moving on to the last High Elves army, commanded by Glowbox. He's bringing again. Very, very similar force. Lots and lots of Eldar Enwë swordsmen. So we're going to go pretty quick over these army comps because they are so similar. You can see the archers. You can see the swordsmen. They look fantastic. I love seeing massive armies of the Eldar Enwë because they look so professional and they look so amazing. And then the final attacking force, we got some humans in the mix. We got the Kingdom of Arnor, commanded by Jesper 96. He's bringing some men at arms in the front line. He's got them really grouped up here, and then he's got a lot of men at arms. He's got some cav in reserve. His general is the bodyguard unit here. He's got the Knights of Annúminas, and then he's got a flanking force over here with really elite troops like the dismounted Dunedain Knights, and they are supported by some Arnorian heavy archers, which are already firing. Just look how cool this is. They are firing. In the background, you can see the tower. There's a small little valley through the cliffs here. They're going to try to flank around the Mordor defenders. Now, let's go ahead and look at the defenders. Mordor, the first one, is commanded by Tembo Ghost. Again, the armies are all very similar. So, we're just going to go super fast through these army comps. Really, I'm just showing you the player names. So, yeah, Mordor, Tempo Ghost, or Tempo.xghost, I should say. There's a lot of orc maulers, orc raiders, just a lot of orcs, a lot of trolls in the mix as well, which is going to make it even more epic. And then the next player is defending this flank right here. We have Untamed Wolf. He's got some Uruks, and then he's got Black Numenoreans. Here's his general, to Nazgul, and then he's got some halberds over here. So this is a bit of a more professional army with skilled Black Uruks ready to go, ready to fight and hold off this great elven, well, I should just say Free People's invasion. So yeah, good mix there. He's also got some orc maulers in the back. So pretty nice force there. The next player is commanded by Sin of the Dark Cloud, the creator of the scenario. He's got some Olog High, and most of his forces were located inside the fortress. So he's kind of storming out, which I love to see. He's actually going to help the defenders who are outside of the fortress. He's not just going to hide behind his walls. So he's got a lot of Uruks, a lot of Halberds back here, archers, raiders, and all that good stuff. Also, Tempo Ghost has some troops back here. Got more trolls in reserve. Of course, I think the Witch King, maybe not. He's got some Black Numenoreans, so he's got some nice cav. He is keeping some reserves in the fortress. I mean, that's a pretty smart idea. You don't want to commit everything. So he does have some reserves back here. And moving on to the next player, which is Happy Meal. Again, very, very similar armies. Uruks, Orc Maulers. He's got the Olog High. There's a bit of a cav fight going on here. The Black Numenoreans taking on some Lancers. Nothing super important, but we got a nice cav engagement early on. And I'm pretty sure that is all of the defenders, the three defending armies. And here comes a nice shot from the catapult. Let's see. Oh, so close, so close. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that's all the armies. So we'll go ahead and do normal speed, get this one started. And this is my favorite part of this opening, or this beginning part of this battle. Just seeing all these orcs cross the bridge from the Great Tower. Look at that. That is so awesome. So they're going to head to the front line and support their allies in a time of need. Support their allies isn't players. They're all, you know, they're all Mordor, so of course they're allies. You know what I mean. Whatever. Yeah, so he's going to disengage there with the Black Numenoreans. He does have his Olog High in the mix. A great anti-cav there, but he's also going to disengage the Olog High. The cav is going to fall back. So you really got to be careful with these the elven cav, because you don't want them flanking around, getting hammer and anvil, and causing a lot of issues for your orc infantry. I mean, the orc infantry, they're already going to have to take care of elven infantry. You definitely don't want them to get, charged in the rear from elven cavalry. Alright, well, let's get a bird's eye view of the situation. You can see he's pushing up some swordsmen. We are going to get an infantry clash here very soon. We got a nice skirmish battle going on here. Orcs, man, they're just so stupid and their lives don't matter. They're firing into the ground. A lot of them are firing into the dirt. Look at that. Come on, use logic here. This is why the evil guys never win. They just have stupid soldiers. But yeah, a nice skirmish going on in this front. Wow, a lot of arrows flying down over here in this elven position. Not a good sight for the elves. And oh, here we go, guys, the first infantry charge. It's going to take place over here on this flank. They're going to charge into the Uruk halberd position. The artillery is going wild in the background. Arrows flying overhead. And I think we're going to get another charge from swordsmen here. So yeah, this might get a little framey at times because of the amount of troops. Fingers crossed that this does not crash. Usually with these massive battles, they are a little unstable and they do tend to crash every once in a while. But I think we're looking good so far. And that is a good thing, obviously. But yeah, the elves are charging in. Now we got the men-at-arms going in as well. Taking on the halberds, and they're really trying to break through this position. And we got more reserves pushing forward from the humans, the Kingdom of Arnor. And the archers are actually falling back, so he did push up his archers, falling back behind his main infantry line here, the dismounted Dunedain Knights. And the skirmish is going to continue on over here. The Orc Raiders are also going to fall back. It looks like Mordor he went for an aggressive move to try to take out those Arnorian heavy archers. Did not pay off, and now he's getting shot in the back with some arrows. So he's going to fall back to the safety of his battle lines here. So let's head back over this. I mean, look at this battle. This is fantastic. Oh, no. This guy's blobbing up. The Kingdom of Arnor is blobbing up his forces. Never a good sight right there. Mordor really needs to take advantage of that. Maybe focus down a lot of arrow fire. Use a couple troops to flank around. Oh, no. What? Why? Terrible. This is why the good guys lose all the time, too. But yeah, Mordor doing a pretty good job. He's got his trolls in the mix as well, holding back the elves. And the halberds holding back more elves on this side. I think there's a lot more fighting going on over in other locations. I mean, this battle is all over the place, so I'm going to do the best I can to, get it all, soak it all in. But we are going to miss certain fighting in certain spots. Can't capture it all. But this, like, this scene right here, having the tower in the background, the elves take on this huge horde of orcs. It's fantastic. The Olag High also in the mix. Oh, this is what I'm talking about, guys. We got some lancers flanking around, going after the orc archers. So that's going to be a big issue that they need to take care of. Also, they've got a catapult that could easily get charged by the enemy cav, so it's got to be careful with that. Nice, we're getting some shots coming in. Oh, good shot right there. Taking it, well, took out two elves. I mean, better than no elves, I suppose. It wasn't a great shot, but it looked cool. So the archers continuing to fire, trying to soften up the orc position, trying to aid their swordsmen in this epic struggle. Got some archers firing at the orc archers up on that cliff over there. The trolls definitely giving that nice support to the orc infantry. They definitely need that support since the orc infantry is so bad. And now I think the elven catapult, the high elves catapult, is trying to go for the troll catapult. Nice shot right there. Let's see if he gets... Oh, and there we go. That's a pretty good one. Took out about 7 of the Mithlin nobles, which is a very tough unit. So that's certainly a unit that you should try to focus down with archers and catapults, because your infantry is going to have a very tough time trying to take him out. But he is now pushing onto the flank. You can see there's no orcs over here defending. And we do have the reserves from Sin and the Dark Cloud showing up right in time, or right on time, not in time. So they're going to come over and try to contain those flanks. You can see he's pushing his Uruks over to that side. And this battle is really, really getting juicy at this point. Let's see what's going on at other fronts. You can see there's a nice fight over here. Catapult fire underway. They're holding right. If you're an orc, you got to be really nervous at this point, because the boss is watching. He is right there watching this battle. Sauron, he's got to be pretty proud of his orcs, right? You can see like a little tear come down. That'd be hilarious. A little tear comes down from the eye as he watches his orcs bravely fight against the free peoples of Middle-earth. Alright, let's witness another shot right here, another catapult shot. They might be getting it a little bit closer. They don't want to risk friendly fire. I guess they're holding fire right there, so we'll move on. We can see that some swordsmen, or actually spearmen, are pushing towards this choke point. We don't have a lot of defenders, but there are some guard over here ready to defend it. And we can see that, oh, the lancers are becoming a huge issue for the defenders over here. So they're going to push into the back lines of the orc back lines there. More swordsmen coming up this side mountain. Maybe the orcs weren't aware that you could actually go up that side, but he doesn't really have his troops in a good position to defend that location. He needs to just charge them and contain the spearmen or swordsmen before they flank around. But let's go back to this main front line. This is very impressive to see right here. A lot of troops fighting it out. Olag High doing their thing. Crushing skulls, taking names. Bodyguards are also engaged in the front line. That's really risky to throw in your general like that. We have the men-at-arms still putting up the good fight on this flank. It looks like he spread out his forces there a little bit, which is good to see. He really clumped them up early on in the battle, but he's being a little bit more wise with his decision making. And if we look over on this side, oh, you can see that the infantry have collided on this front as well. So we got one unit of the dismounted Dunedain Knights taking on some Orc Raiders. Should be able to easily take out the Orc Raiders, but how many units can they get through until they are completely destroyed? That is the question. That is a question that we will soon find out. And you can see the archers back here. Nice archer support trying to take out the Arnorian archers in the very back there. Fire. Shoot. Loose. Whatever. There we go. Yeah. Yeah, probably, you know, he should probably not mix his infantry with his archers, because his infantry is also getting hit by those arrows. Unless he's trying to protect his archers in some manner. Not really sure. But I love it. I just love how we can see different viewpoints of the battle and seeing the great tower in the background. The great eye of Sauron. Alright, so that fight still continues on. This is looking pretty good for the elves in the kingdom of Arnor, the men. They might be able to break through pretty soon here. and really be able to push on other fronts of this defense. You can see the elves are kind of getting surrounded here by some elite units like the Black Numenoreans and the Olag Hai. So that flank has been contained. And gee, look at that. That is perfect. Got the Olag Hai. In the background, you got the fortress.
Barad-dûr.
Excellent. So they're putting up a good fight. Those elves will be crushed right there. They're now containing the elves that are pushing over on this flank. So the front line is still holding for Mordor. They have not broken yet. They do not have to fall back to the fortress just yet. And this is a pretty bloody front on this side as well. The elven cavalry is just, it's been a real issue for these orcs. They don't really have an answer for it. There's a nice charge into some archers there. They're gonna silence them, probably save a lot of lives there. But the trolls, again, I like how Mordor's, you know, I wouldn't necessarily say that the trolls are a good counter to Cav. They're certainly not a bad counter. But I think when you're only down to trolls to take out Cav, it's a pretty good option, you know? So, you get what I'm saying. They're not a direct counter. They're like a soft counter, I guess. Another good hammer and anvil in the back of the orcs there. The elves, with the support of the Mithlin nobles, they might be able to break through here and put some real pressure on that fortress. It cannot fall today. And my god, I hope the defenders win this battle today, because I really don't want to hear it from you guys that the defenders never win. But watch, you know what's going to happen? Watch the defenders win, and since they're evil, you guys are going to be like, ah, the good guys never win. It's like, nobody can win. I can never win. I'm only kidding. I'm only joking. But I at this point, I'm kind of rooting for the bad guys, because their home is under attack. You know, I don't know. I just want to see the defenders win. I really do. So I will pray for that outcome. But we got a lot of orc arrows coming down to the smiths, coming down on the Mithlin nobles. And there's still a lot of a decent amount of archers from the elf side alive. Still trying to put down suppressing fire and support their infantry as they take on this flank. But it doesn't look like the elves are going to have enough here. And the balance of power is in favor. Now, it's hard to trust the balance of power in this situation, because it really looks at numbers. I mean, I guess it also looks at the quality of troops. But I think it looks more at numbers. And the orcs definitely have more numbers than the good guys, because they're not as good quality. So I don't know how true this balance of power is, but so far it's not looking bad for the defenders. And here comes some Olag Hai, swinging their great maces, their great clubs into the Arnorian main line, continuing to hold this position. This side looks kind of rough for the defenders. It does not look good. It does not look good at all. I mean, really, I think the biggest threat for the defenders are the Dunedain Knights. I think they're going to be a huge issue. But, you know, they're actually doing a pretty good job of taking, at least this player, Tempo Ghost, he's doing a good job of taking out this this small flanking force. And he may not destroy this force, but I think he's going to be able to do enough damage to where they won't have enough to be effective later on in the battle. I just got to get that tower in the background. That's just so beautiful. So beautiful. There's a tear to the valley. Alright, he does have some reserves back here, just kind of waiting. I guess he's not sure where to send them just yet. And the Olag Hai, they're still supporting their main orc lines here. We actually have a Black Numenorean general, a Nazgul, going out. Looks like he might be going for some archers. He might be going for the enemy general. Oh, please. This would be so gutsy right here. There he goes. Look at... Charge! Charge! Oh, wait. No. Go for the enemy general. He's sitting right there. I don't think he realizes, but he's going to go for the archers instead, which also... Wait. Nope. He decided not to do that. What is going on with these Black Numenoreans? They are very indecisive creatures. But they are... Yeah, that was not a good charge. And he's going to disengage there little indecisive there that can really kill you on the battlefield. You definitely don't want to be indecisive. We have another general in the mix here. So we have two Mordor generals charging in the back lines. Oh, this is really risky. I see a cave troll catapult, a troll catapult firing down in this position where the generals are located. You don't want to get friendly fire and lose a general that way. But they are holding on. They're actually defeating the forces of Arnor. But we got a lot of golden soldiers over here. A lot of elves who are pushing down on this position. And we've got the generals getting involved over here. Look at that. Look at that. The tower in the background as a cav charges forward. This mod, it amazes me that you think you've seen it all. And I say this all the time. But then there's like a new settlement that you've never seen before, and a new battle, a new environment. It's just like, wow, this is amazing. This is truly amazing. That is why I love modders, because they add so much life to Total War. And I truly appreciate the modding team for Total War, Divide and Conquer, and of course, all the scenario creators like Paladin Bob, Sin of the Dark Cloud, and Kuru Guru Chan, or Chan. You guys add so much life to Third Age. But this battle, nobody's really winning this battle. It's just mostly dead soldiers here, dead orcs, dead elves. And this is just going to be an even trade is what I'm trying to say, where they're going to have no armies left standing on this side. And whoever wins this battle will only have a handful of troops. But who knows who's going to win. Looks like the elves might actually come out on top. The archer's still alive, taking out some orc raiders, also taking out Uruk archers. So yeah, this is just more of a graveyard than a battlefield, which you could say is the same thing. And you can see a lot of orcs, I don't know if they're breaking. No, they are not breaking, but they are falling back. They might be going back into the fortress. Black Numenoreans falling back, which is a smart idea. These guys are really good. You don't want to waste them. And we have an Olag High. An Olag High is just all bloodied up. He's seen his fellow Olag High friends die. He's a little bit traumatized, but he's also very angry. And he realizes, even though he's full of passion and emotions right now, he knows it's the smart thing to do to fall back and defend the strategic choke points of Barad-dûr. Barad-dûr. Alright, but this battle still wages on over here. Rages on. The elves look to be pretty victorious here. But I think, you know, honestly, I think Mordor has done enough. I think that they've done a lot of damage. I think it was a pretty poor assault by the Free Peoples. I think they were a little careless with their assault. Especially with the Kingdom of Arnor, he really charged in his infantry into one big mass instead of spreading them out, maybe even being a little bit more conservative with his forces and not committing them all at once because of all that enemy arrow fire. Oh, get wrecked! This guy's getting destroyed. I love it. That's my favorite animation in this game. There we go. That's one way to take out an orc. Let's see how this fight's going on over here. Look, the Kingdom of Arnor is victorious. And we got a massive retreat. I really hope that they don't just fall back and defend this choke point, because unfortunately, you know, choke point defending can be a bit of a drag, not super exciting. I think just like a little constructive criticism for these custom scenarios. I mean, they're all very great, but I think whenever you fight in siege settlements that have one choke point, you have to defend like right here. Like, this is the final stand right at the beginning of this bridge, and it makes it a little bit more interesting instead of just falling back to a single choke point. But you know, there's still very awesome scenarios. I just think it'd be a little bit more strategic, I guess, a little bit more eventful. Well, let's see what's going on at this final stand. The Olag High not giving up just yet, destroying the catapult crew for the elves, which is a very important target. Some Mithlin nobles charging in, trying to take out these Olag High. We do have some Olag High crashing to the ground. And if we look at the percentage killed, it's pretty even, which again is not good for the attackers. And I also feel very confident that the defenders have enough troops to where they don't have to fall back to a choke point. They could probably rally all of their forces right here and defend and still win this battle. I don't think they have to fall back. Oh my god, that was loud. They don't have to fall back here and defend this location, but let's see what happens here. He's got a good mix of troops. Oh, we actually have a general slain on the battlefield. The elves taking him out. That's okay. You know, the defenders don't necessarily need all their generals because they have infinite morale in the town center. But the elves, I like how they're being aggressive here, not letting these trolls fall back. This is a great move by the attackers. Sometimes you got to be defensive. Sometimes you have to be aggressive. And that's, you know, that's part of the game. You got to determine when it's best to do that action there. You know, you got to figure out when it's best to be aggressive or defensive in certain situations. You know what I'm talking about. But yeah, the trolls, they're you know, even though they got them off guard, they're not going to be able to retreat. These trolls are still going to be able to get tons of kills, or a decent amount of kills at least. And the elves, they're going to be able to cut off any retreating forces. We can see there's actually a general. I believe this is a general. Yes, this is an orc general, or Mordor general, that is stuck out here. So he's going to have to fight it out. Oh, nice. Get some. Killing some elves. Another day, another kill on elves. And we actually have a lot of orcs. They're going to be caught. They're going to be caught out of position. Check this out. So we got Uruks. And we have some Uruk halberds, so three units total, and they're very healthy units. They're actually going to cause some issues for these elves. Will Mordor sally out to try to save them, or will they coward behind their defenses? Let's see. Looks like he's going to coward behind his defenses here. So now the orcs are beginning to charge in to face the spearmen here. This is actually pretty cool. I'm glad that there's going to be another pretty big pitch battle out here in front of the fortress, and here they come. Ready to take out these elves. Or he might. Well, will he try to sneak around them? He's going to be a little too slow. There's no way he's going to be able to sneak around these forces. Also, there's like lava right here. So I don't know if you can actually march on that. Oh, he is actually going to try to run around them. Oh my god. The elves, they better not let them get through. Look at that. They're going to try to sneak their way to the bridge. There's no way though, because the elves are pretty much protecting this bridge. And they are going to... They're going to be able to stop him here. Yeah, you see how he's falling back over here? The elves are going to hold this position. What are these guys doing? Where are you going? Yeah, you know what? They might... Oh, I see what they're doing. Okay. I was like, what? They're going to run into the lava here? No, they're going to form a last stand. And you see that you can't go around them, so they're going to be able to hold one spot. But the archers are already letting loose so many of their arrows into this one unit that they're going to get a decent amount of kills. I don't really know how many more arrows the elves have. Seems like they've been firing for a pretty long time. So, and I think it's going to be really important for them to have a lot of ammo for the late game to be able to push through the defenses. Alright, so most of the fighting has stopped, so what we're going to do here is just fast forward until we finally get some infantry colliding here. I'm not going to cut through it because I think it's going to start up here pretty soon. Yes, finally Mordor realizes that he can't sit back because those elven bows, you know, I think he missed a big opportunity. He could have attacked the elves when they were out of position, but now he let the elves get into position. You can see they formed this nice battle line, and they're going to go ahead and charge in. He's got his archers who are out of ammo. They need to charge in. The general actually charging in. That's a little risky move there. You don't want to lose your general in a careless battle like this. Or almost like a meaningless skirmish that you can easily win. You don't need to sacrifice your general like that. There we go. Finally, he's pushing in the extra elves here. Just quickly surround them. And back here, we have Arnor pushing up what he's got left. Which is a decent amount. Alright, so finally the elves are flanking around these orcs. And that should help turn the percentage kill around. It actually has. The defenders now down to 84, or they lost 85% of their army. 78% of the army, the attacking army, has been killed. So this is pretty huge. Like, this is a large amount of orcs that were caught out of position and are getting slaughtered. I mean, these orcs could have been useful inside the choke points, but instead, they kind of abandoned them, and now they are getting slaughtered. So that is going to be the end of the beginning phase here, and if we just kind of look at what's left of the attackers, they still have a decent amount of troops, but will it be enough to take out what's left of the defending forces? Let's go ahead and look at what the defenders have here, what they have left. You can see that they've got very strategic choke points that are going to be a real pain to take out. There's multiple paths you can take in this fortress, so that's really good to see. It's all about getting past this first choke point. Once you get through here, you're gonna be able to flank around. You can see there's multiple paths, and it's gonna make it really challenging for the orcs to try to defend all these different pathways. So we'll see what happens. Really, it's all about this first point. If the elves can break through this first point without losing too many casualties, I think they're gonna be able to possibly win this battle. So I'm gonna go ahead and just cut out the marching phase here and start it back up once they begin their second assault. All right, guys, so we are back. So you can see here that the elves have knocked down the gates here. They're storming on through. And if we look at the defenders, they're actually not holding this location. So maybe it's a courtesy thing. Maybe they realize that that is a bit overpowered and that they should let them have a chance to storm through multiple choke points, multiple different areas. So they let them in, and now the elves are gonna go ahead and storm in, begin the assault. They are taking out some of the archers, and we have some infantry charging down to support the archers, get them out of there. And now the elven army should be able to storm in here, move in their army, and attack on multiple different locations. So this is pretty cool. I actually really like the fact that the defenders are not holding this single choke point right here, because it makes it a lot more interesting. The catapults are ready to release some nice boulders of justice. Here we go. This is actually a really good spot to do this. The camera's gonna get a little choppy here. So yeah, there's just a ton of orcs in one position, so that catapult should be able to take out a decent amount there. But these elves, it's a small unit of elves, but they're highly trained elves. That was pretty cool. That guy just stabbed him in the gut. He's the banner carrier. Gonna push forward. Keep that banner flowing high. Put fear in the hearts of orcs. The archers now letting loose their arrows. They're gonna get some friendly fire, but it will be worth it trying to take out this very deadly elite elven infantry unit. One of the catapults have been destroyed. From the troll catapult up there. And we do have a bit of an archer battle on the flanks. Got some Uruk archers from Sin of the Dark Cloud firing down. Man, do they have more cav left over? This would be a good time for cav. Let's see what they got left here. I think they should just storm on in now. There's no reason to hold back over here. Just push in, attack on multiple flanks. They do have multiple pieces of catapults, so that's really good to see. And a lot of great infantry, so This battle is going to be a lot closer than you think. Honestly, I was thinking that the defenders would easily take this one, but the attackers still have a ton of troops. So we'll see what happens here. Yeah, and I apologize about the weird camera angles. It's the map. There's nothing I can really do about it. So I'm having my own battle against the awkward map here. So there's two battles going on. Oh, he's got a lot of archers though that have no more ammo. Had a brain fart there. So he's gonna be using them as infantry, but the elven archers they're still a great infantry unit. Unfortunately, they do not have shields, which is not gonna protect them against that archer fire. So that's gonna make it a little bit more challenging for them. But we'll see how it turns out here. We also have a general. Or no, this is just a Black Numenorean pushing on some archers. They definitely need to send more elves over here. They could easily flank around this unit. There's a lot of places to flank around. And I think that's exactly what they're doing. He's going to be moving his archers over to one side. He needs to move fast, though. Or, you know, Mordor's just going to kind of carelessly charge in this unit. He's going to support that main front line. Oh my god, your archers, they're getting attacked from the back. Kill this unit. Another catapult. Another catapult in position here. I think that's the same catapult, actually. A lot of arrows coming down. This is actually really good for the orcs. I don't feel like the elves are really, they're not really doing that great. They're not doing great on this push here. I think they got to keep pouring in more troops. They need to disperse their troops all around the different pathways. I mean, what are they doing? Why are they keeping back so many forces? Like, they should really push on these flanks over here and try to get through and try to get behind and attack these archers, attack these catapults that are just wrecking your troops from afar. But we'll see what happens here. Maybe he's just trying to get them to waste their ammo first and then charge forward. That's the cool thing about these subscriber battle replays is you try to put yourself in their shoes and you try to figure out what their plan is. Sometimes they have no plan. Sometimes they just go in. But we are more than halfway through this battle. It's been a long battle. Certainly been a long battle. I think for time's sake, we're gonna do times two speed here. If you guys don't like it when I do times two speed, I think it's actually better because it's not like we're missing any tactics. We're just kind of, oh my god, this camera. We're just kind of watching the, oh my god, I'm so sorry, guys. We're just kind of watching the main infantry fight in a faster speed, obviously. So the archers are just relentless. I'm afraid to move my camera around. I guess we can kind of look from this point of view. They should use fire arrows and take out the catapults here. That is a little bit of a cheesy strategy. I personally would not do that, but it's certainly an option. And more elves are taking on the Black Numenoreans over here, thankfully. They are committing more forces over to this flank instead of just attacking this main gate right here. We also have some Dunedain Knights in the mix as well. Is he going to flank around? Is he going to charge the back of these Black Numenoreans? Or are they just watching, looking at the view? I don't know. Oh, we got a cave troll. I keep wanting to call them a cav troll. A cave troll force charging down to try to silence the catapult. Now we have some Mithlin nobles charging in to try to protect the catapult against the trolls here. Oh, we got some elves pushing over on this flank. This might be it, guys. This is what I've been waiting for a very long time. There's not a lot of forces defending this side. There's no infantry. He's got some archers he might place up here. Let's see. Come on, move fast. You got to get them by surprise. Let's go. Come on, elves. What is he doing? I guess he's letting them rest. They are very tired. They're exhausted. He also needs to be attacking. The other player needs to attack on this side as well. They need to attack at the same time to put a lot of pressure on their defense. But it just doesn't seem like they're too worried about taking out this position here. He's just pushing up more catapults. I don't get it. Like, I really don't get it. I think this is a perfect opportunity to just storm in and attack those other flanks. Come on, camera. I just want to zoom in. But the elves are actually breaking through here. Balance of power, the percentage kill is actually shifting. This is not looking good for the defenders. Let's see how many more troops they have left. I mean, they still have a nice reserve over here of forces at the town center. So this is going to be really important. This last stand right here. He's got catapults. He's got trolls. He's got a lot of great infantry, Black Numenoreans, generals. It's going to be a pretty solid defense here. But it just seems like he's just putting up a soft defense here. He's actually falling back here. So he's doing a little bit of kiting here. You know, he's just letting them charge in, get some good hits, fall back, fire, fall back. So I think he's just trying to soften up the elves. Yeah, look at this. He's just completely abandoning the locations on this the secondary defense. So I think we're gonna time six speed it here, let the troops fall back, and we are now down to the last like 15 minutes of the battle. He did use some trolls here as a sacrifice unit, try to slow down the elves. He's trying to get his Black Numenoreans up there. They are getting cut down by some of these elves here, but they are going to fall back. And now the final stage of this battle is underway, and the elves are pushing at the final choke point. You can see the gates into the great tower back here. Now, are there multiple points where they can attack, or is it just one point? There's 2 points. Okay, so there's 2 points, which is a lot better than just one, obviously. Sorry, guys. This camera, man. Cameraman, get it? Anyways. So yeah, this great battle still underway. And the Black Numenoreans, this is a really good spot for the Black Numenoreans, because they're going to be able to hold for a decent amount of time against these elves. What is the percentage now? Oh, it's almost even, guys. It is almost even. That's not good for the defenders. But it's not good at all. They had a pretty good advantage percentage killed-wise. But now it's turning back in favor of the defenders. And that usually always happens when the defenders fall back to more strategic locations. They start to get a lot more kills, and they really start to turn the battle around. The Black Numenoreans, they're going to be a real pain to take care of. Let's see what the elves are doing back here. Are they pushing up more infantry? We do have some more forces over here. Is there some fighting going on here? Yes, there's actually some Black Numenoreans down here. Are they still fighting the one? Nope, they finally killed off the Black Numenorean infantry unit here. Now the elves are getting ready for their final assault. They just got to get rid of some defenders here. This nice sacrifice. This great sacrifice from the Black Numenoreans. They take on so many elves. The general close by. They are now surrounded. Getting chopped into pieces. They're skilled warriors, but they can only take on so much. There we go. That's pretty much the last of the Black Numenoreans. Too much to handle. And we'll head back over to this main front where the Black Numenoreans defending this main gate, they are victorious. And the elves, they unfortunately had to fall back. It looks like he's now waiting for reinforcements. I do see a lot of arrows being fired down this way. Let's see. I think he's got some troops pushing. Yes, he does. He's got actually a small force of archers down to 3 men. He might as well hold fire. It's 1 archer now. Just hold fire. Don't waste your ammo. Save it for infantry. Save it for big blobs of infantry. Look, this is actually pretty smart from the High Elves, too. He's going to hide them behind. Look at this. Perfect. Oh, wait. He's still getting hit. But it's still pretty good. He's going to waste a lot of the enemy forces' ammo, which is... Oh, there they go. He's dead. Rest in peace. Rest in peace. Rip in peace. All right. So the force is pushing forward. Finally. And I think this is going to be the final push of the siege battle. We do have a couple archers firing down, not a big deal. He saved his ammo. He's going to attack this huge blob of forces that are now pushing around the flank, which is a smart idea. Maybe he's just trying to get behind the mountain here, or the mountainside, just kind of waiting for more reinforcements. Here we go. He is pushing some infantry to the main front here. He's got some Mithlin nobles now about to join, so we're going to slow it down a little bit. Enjoy the slaughter right here. This is such a cool settlement. It's unfortunate about the camera angles, but overall, it's a pretty awesome settlement. That's just something you have to deal with this game. Very glitchy camera. There we go. They're pushing, and they're really using brute force here. Let's see what's going on the other side. They haven't quite yet get to the front. They haven't gotten to the front line. These archers are really just tearing them apart, turning them into Swiss cheese. But they're going to storm up, try to silence these archers. Let's see. No, I think they're going to be a little too slow there. I don't know. They're catching up to them. This big hill is going to slow them down. Oh, the archers are going to get caught out. Yes, they are. Only barely, though. They need to send down some infantry here, which he does have some infantry. He's got some halberds. This is going to be the final stand of these orcs here. So here we go. They're taking on the Mithlin nobles. They need to send more elves. They need to send more infantry over here. Maybe even a catapult to soften up this defense. Let's head back over to the main defense on this side. The Black Numenoreans are near dead, but we do have some halberds in the background moving up into position. I don't know. This is going to be pretty close, guys. here comes the dismounted Dunedain Knights. A lot of reserves. Look at that. That is insane. That's a ton of troops. They can still win this one, but it's going to be really challenging, especially this position right here. These halberds are going to chew up a lot of these swordsmen. So unfortunately, they... I don't know. Can they push up a catapult? I heard a catapult go off. I think the catapult... Yes! Mordor is now firing their catapults on this side. And the Mithlind nobles are getting chopped up over here, guys. They just don't have a good counter to the halberds. More shots coming in. Trying to take out the back force here of these Eldar Enwë spearmen. Oh, it's getting so close. It's going right over their heads. We also... Oh, look at this. We got some returning catapult fire from the elves. This is desperately needed in this situation to try to soften up those halberds. Let's see if they can get some good hits here. Not yet. Not yet. They need to send up more infantry, that's for sure, though. Oh, nope. Still no good hits there. Let's head back over to the main fight over here. You can see the Dunedain Knights are now in the front line. I think the defenders are going to take this one, guys. I think they're going to take this one. It's tough to say, but I think it's safe to say. They need to pull off a miracle here. Oh, and that's not the miracle they needed. The general has been burnt to a crisp. There we go. He is gone. Did we just watch like a replay of that? That was awesome. So that catapult's getting tons of kills now. That is what the defenders need in this situation. The clumping up of these. Oh my god. Yes. Excellent. Excellent use of the catapults. And these troops are getting burnt alive. He still has a lot of reserves, but this is pretty much it, guys. This right here. And I don't think they have an answer for that catapult. I don't think there's anything they can do about that. So all they can hope for is that they run out of defending troops, which I don't think they're going to be running out anytime soon. Still got a lot of reserves over here. I mean, they've pretty much committed all of their forces. So there's still a chance. There's still a chance. We got some Olag High pushing in. He's actually got a lot of forces over here. He might be trying to break through this attack right here. And then the defenders will charge through this opening here and get behind the other forces. The Olag Hai definitely going to shift this battle, turn the tables on the elves. Not that the elves really had the advantage over here to begin with, but the Olag Hai are certainly going to seal the deal on this front. Now they're just pouring in. The catapult actually right in the face of the defenders or the attackers here, the elves. Olag High crushing their forces. And the elves are actually getting pushed back at this main defense. And the general, look at him. He's fighting with his men, helping them break down this elven assault. And now the generals are getting into the mix. This is the final push, guys. This will decide the battle. And I think... the defenders, like I said earlier, they're going to take this one. They don't have any... Do they really not have any more catapults? They had so many catapults they were pushing in. They're now all gone. Do they have any troops back here? No, they've committed everything. They've committed everyone. And it's just... It seems like the assault here is going to fail against the great, powerful servants of Sauron. Yep, most of the forces have been destroyed over here. Now they're going to continue to push on. Archers in a... Oh, another general burnt to the crisp. A great artillery fire there. And now the forces are going to be free to flank around and destroy what's left of this elven army. So we're going to time 6 speed it here, guys. Because I think it's safe to say who's going to win this one. And thank you, Jesus, that the defenders won this one. I don't have to hear, the defenders win all the time, but I'll probably hear, like, the elves Or the trolls are OP. Less trolls, OP, something like that. Which I don't think the trolls are OP. Really don't. Alright, so that's gonna wrap it up here today, guys. And that is gonna be the battle. So, one thing I want to note, like I said earlier, I think the cool thing with these scenarios, they kind of die down once they push, you know, into these single choke points here. It makes it less interesting. I think having rules where you can only defend, like, it would have been cool if, like, the town center was right here, like, right at the beginning of the bridge. I know it doesn't make a whole lot of sense because there's a whole, like, the fortress is pretty cool on the inside, but, you know, It doesn't play out that great. I just hate those single choke points. But it was a great battle, and the defenders won, so thank goodness for that. But yeah, good defense by the attackers here. Everyone was really carrying their weight, especially a great job to, I can't see the player names. They're all just like characters in Middle Earth. But good game to everyone. I appreciate Sin of the Dark Cloud for making this one. It was really, really excellent. If we look at the kills of the baddies, I'll go ahead and just scroll down. You can, you know, pause it if you want to see some of these kills. See who did really well. 303, the Olog High. There you have it, those trolls. OP trolls. 289, Black Numenoreans. So there you have it, guys. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one. This one was really, really cool, especially the beginning. It reminded me of the last scenario, like, what was it, the Minas Ithil. Really, really cool feel to that battle. I love it's just like instant beginning, massive battles. Really fun to watch. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, be sure to leave a like, a comment, share. And if you haven't subscribed yet and you want to see more epic battles like this one, be sure to hit that subscribe button. So thank you guys so much. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.